So if we're going to be talking about strategies in this game that has an uncertain ending, we can't just write down sequences of actions anymore. We can't just say cooperate, defect, 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 or even some kind of tree of possibilities, because those are going to be finite representations. We need some other representation that allows us to play for an unbounded number of rounds.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to start off by presenting an example of such a strategy, one that's very famous for the iterated prisoner's dilemma, and it's called tit for tat. And the structure of tit for tat goes like this. On the first round of the game, a player playing this strategy will cooperate, and then in all future rounds, the player is going to copy the opponent's previous move. Does that make sense?
It does. So basically, I start out acting as if you're going to cooperate with me, and the moment you don't cooperate with me, I will start to defect, and we'll be in the old-style prisoner's dilemma, right?
What this says is it actually copies the opponent's previous move. So if an opponent goes cooperate, defect, cooperate, defect, cooperate, defect, 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 cooperate, 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 you're going to see something very similar coming out of the tit-for-tat agent.
Oh, I see.
In fact, we can represent the strategy as a little finite state machine like this.
I like that.
And you can see exactly how it kind of proceeds. It starts off cooperating, and then in each round, it waits to see what the opponent does. That's the green letters here. And then it follows the corresponding arrow to determine whether it is going to cooperate or defect in the current round.
Sure, that makes sense.
So in this picture, the black letters here represent my move, and the green letters represent my observation of the opponent's move, or at least if I'm being tit for tat.